The Yellow Wallpaper by Charlotte Perkins Gilman. Hello and welcome to the discourse. Charlotte Perkins Gilman was a prominent American humanist, feminist, short story writer and poet. She was born on July 3, 1860 and died on August 17, 1935. She is known for her literary works based on humanism, feminism and the role of women in society. Her book Women and Economics was published in 1898. In this book, Charlotte argues that the economic independence and specialization of women is essential to the improvement of marriage, family, motherhood, society, domestic industry, and race. Gilman says that human is the only species in which the female has to depend on the male for survival. This dependence forces a woman to pay off her debt as domestic services or sex functions. Gilman suggests that female activities in general are directed by men, which leads to the odd distribution of power that has been detrimental for both genders. Gilman further argues that motherhood is a common duty and common glory of womanhood, and women would choose professions that are compatible with motherhood. The Yellow Wallpaper Summary. Charlotte Gilman was a short story writer, and the most famous of her stories is The Yellow Wallpaper, which was first published in 1892. It is an autobiographical short story. Charlotte married Charles Walter Stetson, who was a famous artist. She initially declined his proposal because she had a gut feeling that her match with Stetson wasn't correct. However, she agreed to his persistence and they married in 1884. In 1885, Charlotte gave birth to the couple's only child, Catherine Beecher Stetson. After her child's birth, Charlotte suffered postpartum depression. She felt so sick that she couldn't walk, stand, or feed herself. She decided to move away from Stetson with her daughter. The couple got separated in 1888 and they divorced in 1889. The Yellow Wallpaper depicts her feelings and experiences during the period of her postpartum depression, her difficulties, and what forced her to get separated from her husband. After her child's birth, Gilman suffered postpartum depression. Her doctor, Dr. Silas Mitchell, suggested the rest therapy with instructions, "Live as domestic a life as possible, have your child with you all the time, lie down and on after each meal, have but 2 hours intellectual life a day, and never touch pen, brush or pencil as long as you live." So, if Charlotte has to live with Stetson, she has to stop writing. It should be noted that The Yellow Wallpaper by Gilman is a short story. British female author Stevie Smith wrote a novel on yellow paper, which was first published in 1936. The Yellow Wallpaper is the story of a woman suffering from mental illness. Her husband keeps her in a locked room for her improvement. The woman is in solitude with no one to talk to or express her feelings. There is a yellow wallpaper on the wall opposite her bed, and she often spends time watching that wallpaper. In the story, the husband of the narrator is also her doctor, and she must do as he demands. Her doctor is her husband, who prescribes her treatment, which is exactly opposite to what she needs. She needs mental stimulation and freedom from that closed room. Charlotte wrote this story to change people's thinking about the role of women in society, emphasizing how women's lack of autonomy is detrimental to their mental, emotional, and physical well-being. Charlotte portrays the narrator's insanity as a way to protest the professional and societal oppression against women. The narrator describes the room in which she has been confined by her husband to suggest the degree to which her husband has imprisoned her. The wallpaper is torn and foul. Windows are barred. There are metal rings attached to the wall. The floor is scratched and gouged and splintered. The bed is bolted to the floor. She describes the yellow wallpaper in a further grotesque manner. Its sickly color, yellow smell, its bizarre and disturbing pattern. The wallpaper is very old and it is missing patches. The wallpaper has so deteriorated that it leaves yellow color on the skin and clothing of anyone who comes in contact with it. As the narrator is confined in the room, she is forced to keep looking at the wallpaper. She gets so engrossed by it that she begins to imagine a figure in the wallpaper. As she continues to think about that figure, she feels that it is a woman who is creeping on her all fours behind the pattern of the wallpaper. The narrator feels that just like her, the woman in the wallpaper is imprisoned and she must be freed. So she starts removing the remaining patches of the wallpaper. The woman trapped in the wallpaper is Charlotte Perkins Gilman herself. She starts imagining herself trapped within the wallpaper. The narrator's husband arrives home after some time, and when he tries to enter her room, she refuses to open it. The husband of the narrator brings his pair of keys to open the room and see her situation. When he enters the room, he finds her creeping around on the floor of the room in a frightening manner. He sees that the wallpaper has been completely turned down and she is rubbing on the wallpaper on the floor while frighteningly creeping on her fours. She exclaims in excitement, "I have got out at last in spite of you." The husband faints and falls on the ground, but the narrator continues to circle around the room. She creeps over the inert body of her husband each time she comes near it, as if it doesn't exist. The ending lines are, "I have got out at last, said I, in spite of you and Jane. And I have pulled off most of the paper, so you cannot put me back." Now why should that man have fainted? But he did, and right across my path by the wall, so that I had to creep over him every time. She meant to say that now I have ripped the yellow wallpaper, my confinement completely, and you cannot imprison me again. The only way for her to get freedom and well-being is to cross over her husband and get separated from him. That is what Charlotte Perkins Gilman did in real life. The yellow wallpaper describes the husband as an antagonist. However, Charlotte continued to have a good relationship with Charles Stetson even after the divorce. Stetson remarried Grace Ellery Channing, who was the closest friend of companion of Charlotte when she got separated from her husband. Later on, Charlotte sent her daughter Catherine to live with her father and Channing at the age of 9. Charlotte married Houghton Gilman in 1900. The Yellow Wallpaper is a feministic short story that is often described as a gothic horror story because of the elements of insanity and weakness and how Charlotte described the narrator creeping on the floor of her dreary confinement. So this was all about the Yellow Wallpaper. We will continue to discuss American literature. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.